So, hello Phil. We are today in Montpellier at the secret place for maybe the end of the European tour.
It's almost the end, yep.
So, how do you feel today?
I feel better now that I had a few drinks. We had a rough night last night in France. A lot of partying last night. But tonight, I feel better. I'm okay.
Okay, yesterday you were in Grenoble.
Yeah.
So how was the crowd there?
Crazy. It was really good. I fell into the crowd. It got ugly, man.
Okay, you had a few countries that were visited by the band for the tour. And you don't add so much dates in France. So how do you explain that?
Well, actually, there was a lot of dates in France. We played about 5 shows in France.
Yeah,
on
5.
We did about 5 shows.
Oh, yeah, okay. So
there was some early in the tour, and now, you know, towards the end of the tour, there's 2 more. So we played like 5 shows in France. But there were like some of the smaller cities in France.
Mm-hmm.
You know, but it was good. The shows were really good.
Okay, at the time you are touring for the last album, Invidious Dominion. Is there a lot of new songs on your current set list?
Yep. Well, we do at least three or four songs a night. You know.
Usually we do 3 songs off the new album.
Sometimes 4, depending on how we feel. Because a lot of people like to hear, you know, there's so many songs.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
So, you know, whatever the fans want to hear, we play it. You know, well, we like playing a lot of the new stuff because it's new.
Yeah.
You know, for us, we've played the old songs for a long time. You know, but we have to play some of the old stuff, you know. Everybody likes the old albums.
Yeah.
I like all of them.
Okay, so far, how were the reactions concerning this new record? That's the second one with the return of Brett. So, do you see that the people are maybe more enjoying the band now?
Oh yeah,
the original singer.
It's definitely, you know, a lot better because Brett's back in the band. You know what I mean? It sounds more like Malevolent Creation. You know, and the music's really good too. I mean, I love the new album. I think the new album is, you know, some of our best work. You know, I mean, we sound like Malevolent Creation. We don't sound like nobody else. We sound like us. So I'm happy.
Okay, considering the feeling in the band, I saw that you've got maybe Jason that is no more playing with you.
No, Jason, long story, man. He does tattoos. He's a tattooist and back at home. He just doesn't have the time to tour as long as we tour, you know. We want to tour a lot.
Yeah, he's...
You know, I mean, he's just... You know, he just doesn't have the time to do it. I don't know if he doesn't want to do it or not, but either way, we're here. You know, there's always people available that want to play with us, so, you know what I mean?
We got the tour manager and stage tech for Napalm Death playing bass with us.
Yeah, his name's John Cook.
John Cook.
And he learned our set list in 2 days. He flew over from England and came over here.
Wow.
We played 1 show with no bass player.
Mm-hmm.
And then we did the Inferno Festival in Norway with him. First show, you know, packed crowd, and he played great, man.
He's a good guy.
Yeah, he's a really good guy, man. We're really, you know, we're probably going to keep him in the band because we're coming back to Europe in June to do some festivals and some touring in Eastern Europe. And, I mean, he's a great bass player, man, a great guy, so.
He rolls with us.
Yeah, man. He keeps it real.
We're international now.
Okay, with the time, the band has suffered of a lot of lineup changes. So, finally, do you think that the thing that won't kill you maybe makes you even stronger? And with the time, that maybe it's a better point?
Yeah, man. I mean, you know, some people, they're just not cut out for it, man. You know what I mean? If you can't fucking stay, you can't commit to the band, then... You should be out of it, you know what I mean?
That's
like me and him still do it because fucking we love it. You know, we love playing music and we like to travel and tour and do a lot of crazy stuff.
But it's pretty good now. I mean, we've got like Gus on drums and Gio guitar. We've had this lineup pretty steady now for a few years. No, Gus has been with us for many years, actually.
The drummer, Gus. He's actually, I've wrote the last 5 or 6 albums with him. Oh. He's always demoed the albums out, but our old former drummer, Dave Kolras, would play on the albums because he could tour, because Gus couldn't tour. But finally, in 2007, Dave Kolras couldn't tour anymore, and Gus joined the band, you know, permanently. And he, you know, we did the new album and recorded it, and we've been touring all over the world with him, and yeah, it's great.
He's kicking it.
He kicks ass, man.
Gio on guitar, he was actually playing bass with us for a little bit, but he's a
guitarist
player.
And he's a really good guitar player, so we've kind of moved him off bass and onto guitar.
And we've known him for many years.
He's been a friend of ours for like 20 years. Time,
so.
Okay, so finally, you are the only one that haven't been replaced.
That's right.
4 years.
I keep it real, man.
Okay, be careful. Maybe the other ones can play something.
I might have to kick myself out.
Okay, as you have this role as the founding guy and maybe the remaining core of the band, more than writing the music and controlling everything about the band, is there some times that you are maybe about tired, about having to manage everything?
Oh, I don't have to do everything. I used to do everything, you know, but now everybody helps. That's what the good thing about the lineup now. Like our drummer Gus helps out a lot with the business stuff. Everybody does. Brett, you know, Gio and Gus. It's easy now. You know, we hired management and we fired management because they suck. And you know, we're just doing things by ourselves again, and things are working better.
Okay, so yeah, with this new album, we told just before that you had 2 record companies, one for the States and the other one for Europe and the rest of the world. So why one of those labels doesn't want to sign you for the world?
Well, Nuclear Blast, we're just licensed. We actually own our albums. Nobody owns them. We own them. My record company, Arctic Music, that I run with our lawyer, ever since the Envenomed album, all the way till now, all those albums, we own them. We license them to these record companies.
Okay.
So we don't get screwed. You know what I mean? So we own these albums. Now we can do whatever we want with these albums for the rest of our lives. And that's the way we're going to keep doing it. You know what I mean? We work with big record companies, but we still own the albums.
We own
the songs. Nobody else owns them. Not like our early albums, like on fucking Roadrunner Records. I mean, they're a good record company. They treated us good, but they still own those first 3 albums. And, you know, if we want them, we got to pay a lot of money.
They want a lot of money for us to buy them back, to buy the rights back. We tried, and it's a lot of money. So... live and learn.
We can still play the songs because they're our songs, of course, but, you know, technically we don't own the publishing and everything like that, but whatever. One day we will.
Okay, it reminds me an old story about the band with the Polish label Metal Mind.
Ooh.
That released a DVD from the band.
Yeah, man, they're a ripoff. They fucking re-released all our albums. Metal Mind bootleg, you know, illegally put out reissues of all our albums. Because in Poland, it's not illegal.
It's the international law.
Yeah,
there's
nothing we can do. We tried to. We tried to get a German attorney and a lawyer, even our lawyer in America, and there's nothing we can do about it.
Wow.
It really sucks. You know what I mean? This company sells all this Malevolent Creations, DVDs and CDs and fucking t-shirts, and we don't get nothing.
Okay.
And
everyone
if I ever see that
us.
Motherfucker, I'm going to kill him. I mean, every time we play Poland, he never shows, he's nowhere to be found. Because if we see him, fuck, he's gone.
Because, yeah, here in France, the sound we had was only considering the DVD. So we didn't know that there was also the Wall discography that was released by them.
Yeah, I mean, the quality is really good. It's a good, you know, but the thing is we didn't say, you know, it's okay to do this. They just did it and said, fuck you, and they released it.
And they make all the money. And
yeah, and, you know, we stopped it from being distributed in America. We were able to stop that, but with eBay and everything like that, you know, people just buy it online.
Yeah.
So, it sucks because we don't, in this music, you don't make much money anyways. But then when someone takes what you do have and they take that money from you too, it's like, you know.
You gotta fucking sign these fucking CDs that fucking, in DVDs that, you know, we make no money night we have to sign autographs. I'm like, you gotta be kidding me, man.
I don't even have a copy of it, let alone anything
else. I had to buy a copy of the DVD. When I was in Germany, I bought a copy like 5-6 years ago. I was like, what the fuck, man?
Yeah, through the years.
Look at this, I don't even have this.
I don't have it either.
What the fuck?
Is that the gatefold
one? Yeah, check this out, man.
That's a nice LP.
It is nice.
I had one. It would be nice. Check it out.
I know,
man.
I've seen it. It's a nice. I don't have one. I'd like to have one. Maybe someday I'll have one.
Open that window.
Yeah.
Froggy,
you're fucking stealing this one.
That's mine.
I want it.
So yeah, through the years, now the band is around 25 and maybe 26 years.
24. 20. That's making crazy now.
Wow. Yeah.
We were little kids when we started the band. You know, 1987. We were like 17 years old.
And yeah, I had in my collection a kind of re-release of the 1987 demo by Jim Nichols.
Oh, yeah, the Chinese label, the Asian label.
It's another one, it's a Shreddy record.
Oh, Shreddy Records. Yeah. She's our original guitar player.
So how do you consider this demo CD?
It's all right. I mean, no, he remastered it. He lives where I live, in the same city as I live. And stuff.
He was the original. He was with the band, with us, me and Brett, in 1987, but he's only on the first demo. We did 3 demos before we did the first album. But, you know, just recently he's gotten involved, you know, because of the demo and the internet and everything. And he actually did some cool things because, you know, he got these labels to release the demos.
And they actually give us money for it.
They actually pay us.
Wow.
All the way from China.
Yeah, they didn't just steal it.
And they did a good job of it, too, man. They made the vinyl, you know, a gatefold album with old photos, you know, when we were 17 years old.
Mm-hmm.
And they put it on CD and everything. It's like 3 songs, the original versions, and then the remastered, which sound a little bit better. But it's really cool because, you know, we were little kids, you know, when we did that demo. It sounds, you know, it sounds like Slayer and Creator on crack.
Okay, what kind of relations do you have with the former members? Is there some with you are totally fucked off and pissed by those guys?
Actually, we're friends with all the ex-members. Everybody, pretty much. Nobody left on bad terms. You know, everybody was a mutual thing. You know, like, hey, okay, you don't want to be in the band, then see you later. But we're still friends. You know what I mean? You know, it is what it is.
Mm-hmm. I still talk to Rob a lot. Okay.
Yeah, we talk. I mean, I love all those guys. Those guys are all a big part of this band, or you know, at some point, but. They didn't want to go didn't want to go to the distance.
Yeah. Okay, with the time, do you have a kind of cooking method to compose the songs? Do you need a special state of mind to start to create some riffing or some...
Yeah, well, of course.
Vodka?
I mean, no.
I'm kidding.
No, I mean...
A state of drink or a state of mind?
When we know that we have to do it, that's when I sit down and I start playing, you know, write music, and then we get together as a band. Me and the drummer, usually me and the drummer, Gus Rios, we get together, we make demos of the songs, we send them to him, and he writes the lyrics, and then we go to the studio and do the album. You know, it's pretty weird, but I mean, it always works.
Do you need?
We never even know what the lyrics are going to be like.
We never know.
The last albums, we have no idea. He comes from New York to Florida. Okay, let's go. He just sings over the music, and it's perfect. But we've been playing music for so long, me and him, since we've been like fucking 12 years old. You know what I mean? Since we were little kids, we've known each other. I really don't have to worry. You know what I mean? I write songs, and I think how he's going to sing them, and then when he comes and sings them,
he's doing
perfect. I have no complaints. You know, I'm like, can't say nothing bad about it.
We've been doing it for a long time, so it's kind of like, you know, we practice in the warehouses for years and years every day, every day. We know how we play together.
We're brothers.
Yeah.
But, blood brother.
We are, man. We've known each other since we've been like 7 years old.
Yeah.
But so we know how we think and how the music, you know, it's...
We know what we like. You know what I mean? After all these years of playing music together and being friends, we know, you know, he knows what I like and I know what he likes, so it works.
Okay, and do you need only to have the pressure of a new recording to compose? Or do you have maybe spare time or holidays when you are...
I like the pressure.
I like the pressure, actually, yeah. I like when they say, gotta do a new album. Then and that's when we talk and we say, okay, let's start working, man.
I get in the studio and it's my thing, and some songs, I redo them. Because I hear them in the studio, and then I get a different, you know, and they're recorded different in the studio than like on a, you know, a demo. Then I get different ideas, you know, because you got to get, you get flowing.
Yeah, because, you know, we make demos of all the songs.
Blood going, you know.
So, okay.
When you get in the studio, sometimes things change for the better, though.
I think it's better that way, because then it's, it gets you...
More spontaneous.
Yeah, it's more real than if you keep thinking about it and do it, and you lose the edge.
We like to walk the thin line, man. You know,
we never know what to expect. Absolutely.
Okay, and Brett, how do you consider the Kyle's work on the albums you weren't in the band? And do you know the guy?
Oh yeah, Kyle. I know Kyle very well. He's a good friend. I like singing those songs. I change them around a little bit for my style, but I like playing the songs.
We play some of the song, you know, those songs too, you know. But he sings them the way he sings them, and it sounds more like Malevolent Creation, you know. So it works out because I wrote the music, still Malevolent Creation, but when he sings it, it really sounds like Malevolent Creation.
Yeah, I have fun with it, you know, because to me it's kind of new, you know. It's already written. I don't have to write it. But I have fun with it because they're cool
and
songs.
Plus,
Kyle's
a good singer, but he was a really big fan of Malevolent Creation, a big fan of him. So he wrote the lyrics just like, you know, kind of like in the style that he would write them. You know, the songs are about real things, you know, death, the very various forms of death. You know, we don't write about fake stuff and fucking zombies and fucking ghosts and shit like that.
Ghosts.
You know, our lyrics are about fucking things that really are for real.
Okay, with this new album, there are two live tracks as bonus songs. And
oh yeah, we did it from Australia.
Yeah, and
I never heard them.
It's written that it's extract from a DVD.
Yeah.
And what about this DVD?
I haven't seen it yet.
I look for it everywhere. And
it's coming out. The album's out. The live album's out. But the live DVD is coming out like any day.
Oh, yeah.
I haven't even seen it
yet. I haven't seen it yet. I haven't heard it. Oh, yeah. I heard it, but I signed
some of them. I autographed some, but I don't have one myself yet.
Okay.
So it's
hopefully you are playing on it. Hopefully you are playing on it. But
I'm on it. But I don't own it.
I don't have a copy.
Wow, that's incredible.
That's us.
That's how we roll.
Okay, so what are the future plans? Now we are in April 2011. So in the next month, do you plan only to tour?
Yeah, we come back here to Europe in June.
Hellfest.
Back to Europe to do some touring, and I think then after that we do some South America, Central America.
Well, we're gonna keep touring.
And then we'll do another album.
We'll
write a fucking album that's even faster.
Wow.
Number 12.
We'll do one. We're just gonna keep touring right now for.
Yeah, we have so many albums. We have a good album out now. and we just, you know, we're gonna just travel and tour, play and have fun and keep it real.
Okay, for 24 years you are now in the touring business. Do you consider that for a death metal act, it's easier to book shows and tours than maybe 20 years ago? Or harder?
We've never had a problem because people always want to book our tours. So, you know, but now the only thing that's bad is that the internet, you know what I mean? Bands, I mean, we always tour. We've always toured. After every album we release, we tour. You know, we always play live. But now you really have to play live because everybody's fake. You know, these albums you hear, they're all Pro Tools and digital. We still record the albums the way we did in the old days.
Old school,
man. We get in the studio. We really play what you hear on the albums and what we're doing.
And we'll do it on stage.
And we play it on stage. And even faster.
It'll be better live than on the
album. You know what I mean? So, you know, we keep it fucking as real fucking gets. Honestly, I mean, we really do.
You'll hear it tonight.
There's a lot of the old bands too, man. A lot of the, you know, old death metal bands, they do the same thing. It's strange for us to not do it like that, you know, because back in the old days, you had to get in, you know, a rehearsal room and practice every day and write songs and do it. That, we still do that. You know what I mean? We don't share files on the internet. Hey, man, I got a new riff here, Brett.
You know, they record a thing on a CD and send it to me, and I put it on a freaking little boombox. I don't even have a stereo. I put it on there and go, stop, rewind, stop, rewind. You know, that's how I roll.
Yeah, man. I mean, you know, we're still as old school as it gets, man. I don't want to do it the new way, man. I mean, if we can't play our own songs all the way through, then we shouldn't be playing.
Mm-hmm. You'll know. You see us live, and you'll know, man. We roll.
That's why we tour a lot, because we want people to see that we can fucking play our fucking songs.
We play the fuck
out
of
them. And in a fucking computer fucking making our songs sound good. We really are that good. I mean, what you hear on our albums is what you fucking hear for real, man. I mean, I'm not tooting my own horn, but fuck it, that's the truth. I mean, that goes for probably a lot of bands that are like been around as long as us. You know, they do the same thing. Bands like Obituary and Morbid Angel and Deicide, they fucking actually fucking rehearse, you know, as a band and play. You know, nowadays everybody just, you don't even have to go to a studio. It's fucking all fucking email fucking files. Fuck that. That's fucking gay.
That's how you play better on a stage, because you know each other's things. I mean, if you just go through that, there's not that connection on stage. You know, when we play a stage, we have a good time. You know, we look at each other, we laugh, we kick some ass, and we play together good because we play all the time. We play together. It's not fake stuff, it's not this and that. What you see is what you get, it's real. We go up there and we have a goddamn good time kicking everyone's ass.
Hand me that bottle.
Bartender.
Thanks, bartender.
But, you know, that's the way we roll. We like to play live, and we like to have a good time on stage and play our music. People hear it, and they go, Jesus Christ. You know, they go, what the fuck, and kicking some ass. We play, you know, when we tour, we play every freaking night. You know?
Yeah, man.
We have a night off, and it ain't because we want it. We like to go every night, play every night. You know, when people go, ah, how do you play that many shows? Go, it's normal.
We don't have days off. We don't believe in it.
Yeah. It's not enough yet to use a...
Oh, shit.
Try that. Maybe that'll work.
What's up, Cookie?
Here's Cookie. That's John Cook.
What up?
That's our bass player.
He's a tour manager. He's stage tech for Napalm Death. He's bass player for Malevolent. He's an all-around utility infielder. He's a good man.
He's all right. We love him. We took him in as one of us.
Okay. I saw that an album was produced by Gus. I think it was Doomsday.
Yeah, yeah. He's the drummer. He's a producer too.
And the new one is produced by Eric.
Eric Rutan. Yeah.
So why this choice to not save Gus as producer?
Because Eric's really good.
You know, Eric's almost like Scott Burns back in the day.
He's the Scott Burns of now. You know what I mean? He's old school like us. He won't do a band. He won't record a band unless they can play. You know what I mean? He won't sit there and fix your music and make you sound good.
Best copy and
fuck that. He won't do that, man. If you can't play it, he won't record it. And that's what I like about him, man. And he's a really good, he did a really good job with, like, the Cannibal Corpse albums. When we heard that, you know, he's a good friend of ours. I've known him since 1989 when he was in Ripping Corpse. He's a great guitar player.
Yeah, he plays the band. He plays the band,
you know, he's a musician, so he knows, you know what I mean? And recording him with him was so fucking cool. We did the whole album in 9 days. That's it, 9 days. We was done.
We don't need to take a lot of time. Not up in here.
Not up in here!
Okay, so what can we wish to the band? Are you ready for almost the next 25 years?
Oh, come on, let's not get crazy.
Hey, if I look this good after 25 years, who, the sky's the limit. we'll just keep touring if people want to keep hearing us.
We're going to play until we're not happy. You know,
we're not happy if the fans and people aren't happy, then we'll stop. But, I mean, for now, well, I got no reason to stop. You know, I feel good. It keeps me young and keeps me happy.
We're having fun, man. You'll see it tonight.
That's great. I know the band.
Fuck yeah, man.
So, thanks for your time.
Thank you.
Peace.
And I wish you the best.
Keep it real.
Thank you.
Bye.